It's summertime, and households across the nation are tuning up their lawnmowers and dusting off their weed whackers to take care of that patch of grass surrounding their house. But those lawnmowers, they create carbon emissions. And how about the weed killers and fertilizers you put on your lawn? Well, they have chemicals that seep into the groundwater. So, exactly how much impact does your lawn have on our Earth?
So we could talk about 4 or 5 different categories of environmental impacts. You could talk about carbon emissions, you could talk about air emissions. Obviously a lawn like this consumes water, not just from the sky, but from irrigation. Talk about nutrients we would apply to a yard like this to keep it looking healthy, as well as natural or otherwise weed control.
So in the carbon emissions area, I mean, we talk about these different types of lawnmowers. How do you compare those different lawnmowers?
So there are 3 broad types. So you can think about a lawnmower that runs on gas, one that runs on electricity, or one that runs on human power. Gas is the big loser environmentally. A yard like this, so we're looking at about just under 1/4 acre or so, that's going to be about 400 pounds of CO2 emissions, roughly, from gas. When you go to electric, it's going to cut that roughly in half. And if you have a push mower without an electric or any kind of motor assist, that's going to be obviously no carbon, right, except what you exhale, I guess. Right?
So the chemical weed control methods, I mean, what's your take on that?
Hey, organic is better. The question is, these yards are so hooked on drugs that you can't just apply anything. So you talk about the fact that lawns are very unnatural. This actually is mostly Kentucky bluegrass, and last time I checked, we're not in Kentucky. So it actually takes work in terms of irrigation. It takes work in terms of nutrient application, and nutrient pollution is actually a big deal. So there's a retention pond just a couple of doors down here. It retains some of the water during the storms, and what you'll see is that will actually turn quite yucky in a matter of a month from now or so. More people apply nutrient to the yard, it'll become a greenish algae muck. Now, that's a local issue. You see nutrient pollution in lakes, in oceans even.
So what about the water consumption? I mean, how much water are we putting into our lawns?
This yard, we're able to get away with about 100 gallons a day. When we start throttling back from there, which you might do on occasion, it'll start to turn brown. But if you've lived here long enough, we've been here for about 10 years, I know how brown it can get before it won't come back.
What about those big areas of grass? We're talking
golf courses.
Golf courses, yes. What kind of impact is
that? Some of the numbers there just kind of blow your mind. So, an average golf course in the U.S. might use over 300,000 gallons. So, that's like 1,000 to 10,000 homes. At residential rates, you'd be looking at like $1,500 a day.
Wow.
And it's not just about the water consumption. The water's got to come from somewhere. You pump it, then it gets treated, it gets pumped back. So there's a lot of energy involved in supplying that water as well.
We say lawns are unnatural, right? So what are some alternatives that we can do to a lawn that would be a more sustainable solution?
You could talk about matching the plant species and even matching the grass, if you're going to have grass, to your soil type and to the microclimate that exists around the house. And if you were to do it over and it was within the association bylaws, you've got real options.
Lawns are a part of American culture, and they're probably not going anywhere. But sustainability is all about personal choices. Your lawnmower use, water consumption, and chemicals all have an environmental impact. It's really all about finding the right balance.